Good morning everyone and welcome to the class. Today we will start your second book. The book is Politics in India Since Independence. And as the name suggests, the whole book deals with politics from 1947, which started in 1947 and up to current time. So we see the name of the first chapter is Challenges of Nation Building. What the country was facing at the time of independence was the challenge of nation building. Other than this challenge of nation building, there were other challenges as well, like we will discuss about other challenges also, but the first chapter deals with challenges of nation building. What challenges was India facing in order to be a nation? What were the problems the country was facing in order to be a nation? So first of all, we will see the problem which our country was facing at that time was the problem of partition. Okay? How the partition took place, what was the process, what were the problems which were associated with the process of partition, then what were the consequences of partition. We will discuss all these things, and then we will discuss the next challenge which the country was facing at that time was the integration of princely states. That was also one of the most important challenge, and the next challenge which the country was facing for becoming a nation was the demand of the different states about the reorganization, that is reorganization of the state. So under this challenge of nation building, we are going to discuss on these three. Pehla, partition. Dusra, integration of princely states, and the third one is reorganization of states. These are the three challenges of nation building. But before going into details of these challenges, what we need to understand that our country became independent on 15th August 1947, and we see that Pandit Nehru, he was the first Prime Minister of Free India, and he addressed a special session of the Constituent Assembly on the midnight when India got independence, that is at the midnight of 14th-15th August. And ab 14-15 August ka jo beech wala midnight ka time tha, us samay 12 baje, raat ke 12 baje, unhone ek he addressed a special session of Constituent Assembly, and the speech which was delivered by Pandit Nehru on that night is known as Trust with Destiny. So this is very important. This is very important speech which was delivered by Nehru. The name is very important. Many times it comes in the board examination. The name of the speech which was delivered by Nehru. So that speech is Trust with Destiny. So what is this Trust with Destiny? What does it mean? Destiny jo hamare samne khadi thi, azadi mil gayi hame, है ना, नाउ वी आर अ फ्री कंट्री। सो अब इस डेस्टिनी के साथ हमारी मुलाकात हो रही है, ट्रस्ट, हम उनसे मिल रहे हैं अपनी डेस्टिनी से, है ना। जो हिंदी में आपके एनसीईआरटी की हिंदी की बुक में जो वर्ड यूज किया गया है, दैट इज रियली ब्यूटीफुल वर्ड। द वर्ड्स आर नव वधू, नव वधू से चिर नववधू से चिर प्रतीक्षित भेंट वार्ता। ठीक है, यहाँ पर नववधू क्या है, जो आजादी हमें मिली, द इंडिपेंडेंस, द फ्रीडम विच वी गॉट आफ्टर द स्ट्रगल ऑफ अराउंड 100 इयर्स, 100 सालों की लड़ाई के बाद जो आजादी हमें मिली, दैट इज लाइक नववधु, एक न्यूली वेड जो ब्राइड होती है, उसका जब घर में आने पर जो खुशी होती है, दैट इज एक्सप्रेस थ्रू दिस टर्म। और नववधु से चिर प्रतीक्षित, चिर प्रतीक्षित का मतलब क्या हुआ, जिसकी प्रतीक्षा, जिसकी जिसका इंतजार बहुत दिनों से हो रहा था, है ना, 200 सालों की गुलामी थी, 100 साल की पूरी लड़ाई थी हमारी, और तब जाके ये आज़ादी हमें मिली थी। तो ये कैसी आज़ादी है, ये जिसके जिसके लिए हम बहुत सदियों से, 200 साल की गुलामी से हम आज़ाद हो रहे हैं, तो ये इसके हम बहुत दिनों से इंतज़ार कर रहे थे कि कब हमें मिलेगी आज़ादी। जैसे एक जो न्यूली वेड जो दुल्हन होती है, जो ब्राइड होती है, उसके लिए जैसे इंतज़ार किया जाता है कि वो कब आएगी घर में, तो उसी तरह से इस इंडिपेंडेंस, इस फ्रीडम का भी लोग इंतज़ार कर रहे हैं। और जैसे अब हमारे अगर इंडियन कल्चर को हम देखें, तो हमारे कल्चर में ऐसा माना जाता है, कई बार इस तरह की चीज़ें होती हैं, हालांकि दीज आर नॉट दैट इम्पॉर्टेंट, बट स्टिल यहाँ पर नववधू जो यूज़ किया गया है वर्ड, उसके पीछे जो रीज़न है वो यही है कि कई बार ऐसा माना जाता है, जो इसको हम डेस्टिनी के साथ जोड़ रहे हैं ना, यहाँ पर इंग्लिश में जो डेस्टिनी वर्ड यूज हुआ है, उसके लिए ही ये नववधु आ रहा है ना। तो व्हाट इज द कनेक्शन बिटवीन डेस्टिनी एंड नववधु, बिकॉज इट इज कंसिडर्ड इन आर कल्चर, इन द इंडियन कल्चर, की व्हेन ब्राइड कम्स टू आर होम, सी ब्रिंग्स गुड फॉर्चून फॉर अस, है ना। जब कोई ब्राइड घर में आती है, हालांकि ये बातें आई डोंट बिलीव इन ऑल दीज थिंग्स, बट यहाँ पर जो कहा गया है उसका यही मतलब है कि जब कोई नई दुल्हन आती है, तो वो अपने साथ गुड लक लेकर आती है, गुड फॉर्चून लेकर आती है। तो उसी तरह से ये जो आज़ादी हमें मिली है, इतने लंबे वर्षों के इंतज़ार के बाद आज जिस आज़ादी से हमारी मुलाकात हो रही है, ट्रस्ट हो रही है, वो आज़ादी भी हमारे लिए बहुत सारे उससे हमारे बहुत सारे एक्सपेक्टेशंस हैं, है ना, कि आज़ादी मिलने के बाद ऐसे होगा, ये होगा, हमारी लाइफ ऐसी होगी। तो हमें ये लगता है कि वो हमारे लिए गुड फॉर्चून लेकर आ रहा है ये आज़ादी, है ना। तो ये नेहरू के ये बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट है आपके लिए, ट्रस्ट विथ डेस्टिनी। तो यहाँ पर डेस्टिनी जो है वो इंडिपेंडेंस को माना गया है, कि जो हमें इंडिपेंडेंस मिली है उसके साथ आज हमारी पहली मुलाकात है 12 बजे रात को, और ये हमारे लिए अब हमारी लाइफ में क्या कुछ होने जा रहा है। इट्स नॉट दैट एवरीथिंग इज गोइंग टू बी गुड, बिकॉज अगर हम देखें तो बहुत सारे हमारे सामने प्रॉब्लम्स हैं, बहुत सारे वी कैन से दैट द कंट्री वॉज बॉर्न इन अ वेरी डिफिकल्ट सर्कमस्टांसेस, एंड वी कैन से दैट परहैप्स नो अदर कंट्री बाय देन वॉज बॉर्न इन सच अ सिचुएशन इन विच इंडिया वॉज बॉर्न, बिकॉज वी नो फ्रीडम केम विथ पार्टीशन ऑफ द कंट्री, है ना। एंड दिस द ईयर 1947 सॉ अनप्रेसिडेंटेड वायलेंस एंड trauma of displacement. People were getting displaced. The Muslims were going to Pakistan from India, and the Hindus were coming to India from Pakistan, and that displacement was a real trauma for the people. The violence. So in this situation, independent India started its journey. You know, the journey was started at a very different circumstance, and in front of this independent country, so many objectives to be achieved. You know, बहुत सारे objectives थे हमारी country के सामने जो कि हमें achieve करना था. And yes, the conditions were very difficult. Still, what we find that our leaders, they did not lose sight of the multiple challenges that faced the new nation, and they were ready. The leaders were ready to face the challenges, and not only the leaders, but the people were also ready to face the challenges. So this is the we can say situation when India got independence. And now we see what were the challenges in front of our country. कौन कौन से चैलेंज थे जो कि हमारी कंट्री उस समय, एट द टाइम ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंस, आर कंट्री वॉज फेसिंग. ब्रॉडली वी कैन डिवाइड दीज चैलेंजेस इंटू थ्री पार्ट्स. ठीक है, तीन तरह के चैलेंजेस हम लोग फेस कर रहे थे. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वॉट वी सी दैट जो इमिडिएट चैलेंज था वॉज द टू शेप अ नेशन. है ना, टू शेप अ नेशन दैट वॉज यूनाइटेड, but at the same time there should be accommodation of the diversity in our society. United chahiye tha, we wanted to be united as a nation, but not at the cost of suppression of diversity. We wanted, our leaders were of the opinion, and as well as people were also of the opinion, that diversity should not be suppressed. Unity with diversity. We wanted unity, but not at the cost of suppressing of the diversity, but we wanted unity with the accommodation of the diversity. And so that was the first challenge, how to shape a nation with unity and diversity. And we know our country is full of diversity. First of all, we see the size is very big. You know, we can say that our country has a continental size, and with this, we find that diversity is also there. Like, people speak different languages, they follow different culture and religions. This is not the condition of present time. The same situation was prevailing in the year 1947 as well. People spoke different languages, people followed different culture and religion, and it was believed many people were of the opinion that a country which has so much diversity could not remain together for long. And many times it is alleged by the Western thinkers that India is not a nation. Why? Because of diversity. There is no binding factor for India. Because if we see the countries of Europe or other countries, like Western countries ko jab bhi dekhte hain, to we find that there is uniformity of language. People are bound together with on these bases, like language, religion, culture. But in our country, we have so much diversity. So there was apprehension that the country which is full of such kind of diversity could not remain together for long. And not only this, we can say that the partition which occurred in 1947, that was also proving this, that it will be really difficult to unite India as a nation because of diversity. And so many serious questions were there about the future of India. Would India survive as a unified country? Would it do so by emphasizing national unity at the cost of every other objective? In order to become a nation, it should have to sacrifice, or we can say it has to bring unity at the cost of other objectives. Like it has to bring unity at the cost of accommodation of diversity. You cannot. It was the apprehension that the country cannot be unified in the absence of suppression of diversity. If you want to be united as a country, then you will have to suppress the diversity. So how India will become a nation? And how was the integration of the territory of India to be achieved? Kaise achieved kiya jayega? That was the biggest question, because of diversity. And we can say that the partition has actually made the condition worse. है ना? तो ये जो हमारा, this is the first challenge. The challenge was to shape a nation. To shape a nation, to shape a united nation, and इस shaping of the united nation के अंदर जो problems थी, वो challenges, इसके अंदर जो challenges थी, एक तो diversity हो गई, दूसरे partition हो गया, तीसरा integration of princely states हो गया, और उसके बाद reorganization of states हो गया. ठीक है, तो ये सारे challenges जो हैं वो united nation के रूप में save करने में आ रहे थे. अब हम देखेंगे second challenge क्या था. What was the second challenge? The second challenge was to establish democracy. So what we find that in class 11th you have read about Indian Constitution at work, and you have seen the provisions of Indian Constitution. We have seen that our Constitution grant us fundamental rights and extend the right to vote to each and every citizens, adult citizens. Then our Constitution has adopted representative democracy, which is based on the parliamentary form of government. All the provisions in the constitution were made for this establishment of democracy. But here you must understand that only by making provisions in the constitution, democracy cannot be established. What is important for democracy is the democratic practices. Okay, only by making provision in the constitution never ensure the establishment of democracy. If we really want to establish a democratic government, what is required? That the country must develop democratic practices. So that was also a challenge, because our country has never experienced democracy. Before this colonial rule of British, we have monarchy. You know, we were under monarchical system, and people were completely unaware of the democratic principles and elements and features and all. And during the colonial rule also, what happened that there was complete absence of democracy. People were not given any kind of right, people were not considered equal, discrimination was there, people were not given any kind of rights. So it was one of the most important challenge, that how to develop democratic practices in the country. Okay, now we will see the third challenge. The third challenge was to ensure the economic development with social justice. Okay. to answer economic development with social justice. Okay, so what was the challenge? The challenge was to bring economic development, because what we see that during the colonial rule, we were exploited economically. Agriculture was exploited. No attention was paid on the industrial development or any kind of science and technological development. So there was exploitation, and the result was the economic backwardness of the country. And this was one of the most important challenge in front of us when we become independent. But at the same time, our aim was not only to achieve economic development, but we wanted to achieve economic development with social justice. It means that our leaders were very much aware of the importance of social justice. It means that there should be well-being of the entire society and not only of some section. Okay, there should not be a gap between the rich and the poor. The all people who are living in the country, they must be their basic needs must be fulfilled. And for that purpose, our constitution has also made provisions, like the constitution lays down the principle of equality and special protection to that group which is socially disadvantaged. And not only this, the religious and cultural communities were also given a special protection by the constitution, as you have read in the class 11th book. हमारे कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में इस बात का पूरा प्रोविजन किया गया कि जो सोशली डिसएडवांटेज ग्रुप है, लाइक शेड्यूल कास्ट, शेड्यूल ट्राइब्स, उनके लिए स्पेशल उनको प्रोटेक्शन देने की जरूरत है. देन जो हमारे रिलीजियस, कल्चरल एंड लिंग्विस्टिक माइनॉरिटीज हैं, उनको प्रोटेक्शन दिया गया थ्रू फंडामेंटल राइट्स. तो कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ने सारे प्रोविजंस किए थे, लाइक डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल ऑफ स्टेट पॉलिसी वाज आल्सो अडॉप्टेड, विच सेज दैट द डेमोक्रेटिक पॉलिटिक्स मस्ट अचीव द वेलफेयर गोल्स. एंड इन ऑर्डर टू अचीव दिस वेलफेयर गोल्स, व्हाट शुड बी द पॉलिसी ऑफ द स्टेट, है ना. So now the challenge was to evolve effective policies for economic development as well as eradication of poverty. That is economic development with social justice. So these are the three challenges our country was facing at the time of getting independence. Now how independent India responded to these challenges? And we can say to what extent our country succeeded in achieving the various objects set out by the constitution. So we will have a look on all these questions in the entire book. The whole book is about these three challenges only. Okay, so we will be starting with this chapter, Challenges of Nation Building. And as I told you, our focus will be on three important elements, which or we can say three important challenges which comes under this category to shape a united dish. The first challenge was partition, the second was integration of princely states, and the third one is reorganization of states. Okay, now we move to the problem of partition. Okay, पार्टीशन अगर हम देखें तो जस्ट आई एम राइटिंग डाउन So as we know, we got independence with partition of the country. Country was divided into two nation states, that is India and Pakistan. And we see that because of partition, what happened that the British India was divided into two parts, India and Pakistan. And the boundary was drawn between these two countries. The territory of each country was marked, and this was not an easy task. And we see that why this partition occurred. ये partition हुआ क्यों? तो इसके लिए जो मैं that is most important and the most we can say the reason which was responsible for this partition is the two nation theory which was advanced by Muslim League. Here you must understand that in India Muslims were in majority in जो India before independence था British India जो था अगर उसमें हम देखें तो Muslims were in minority and Hindus were in majority. And जो elections हो रहे थे provincial elections हो रहे थे 1935 के Government of India Act के accordingly 1937 में जो elections हुए उन elections के result से मुस्लिम लीग इस बात को समझ चुकी थी कि इंडिया में उनकी जो स्टेटस होगी वो माइनॉरिटी वाली ही होगी और उनको बराबरी का जिसको कहा जाए वो हक नहीं मिल पाएगा. और एक ये इनसिक्योरिटी आ रही थी मुस्लिम लीग के लीडर्स के मन में कि ब्रिटिश रूल तो अभी है तब ये तो ठीक है ब्रिटिश रूल है, जब ब्रिटिश रूल खत्म होगा फिर हम ब्रिटिश रूल खत्म करने के लिए लड़ाई लड़ रहे हैं, जब ब्रिटिश रूल खत्म होगा भारत आजाद होगा तो वो दैट ब्रिटिश रूल विल कन्वर्टेड इनटू हिंदू रूल. व्हाई? बिकॉज द हिंदूज आर इन मेजोरिटी. सो दैट वाज अ काइंड ऑफ इनसिक्योरिटी व्हिच वाज देयर इन द माइंड ऑफ द मुस्लिम लीडर्स. एंड सो व्हाट वाज द डिमांड इफ वी सी द प्रोसेस ऑफ व्हेन दिस प्रोसेस ऑफ ट्रांसफर ऑफ पावर स्टार्टेड. एज वी नो ड्यूरिंग द सेकेंड वर्ल्ड वॉर Italy has declared that India will be given freedom after the end of the Second World War by 1948. कहा गया था कि 1948 तक इंडिया को आजादी दे दी जाएगी. ठीक है, अब यहाँ पर जब आजादी की बात हुई तो ये जो इनसिक्योरिटी मुस्लिम लीग की थी वो सामने आ गई कि वो उनको लगता था कि हिंदू मेजोरिटी में है तो ये हिंदू रूल हो जाएगा. और इसी कारण से हम देखते हैं जो कैबिनेट मिशन प्लान आया उसमें जो कुछ भी तरीके से प्रेजेंटेशन को बताया गया उसको एक्सेप्ट नहीं किया गया, क्योंकि मुस्लिम लीग का जो कहना था वो ये था कि एक्चुअली अगर देखा जाए, हम इसको बहुत शॉर्ट में करके उसके जो एसेंस है उसको देखते हैं तो यही समझ में आता है कि मुस्लिम लीग का जो क्लेम था वो ये था कि दो दे आर इन माइनॉरिटी, उनका नंबर कम है, बट रिप्रेजेंटेशन वो बराबर चाहते थे, उनको रिप्रेजेंटेशन उतना ही मिले जितना कि हिंदुओं को मिल रहा, जो कि कांग्रेस के लिए ने एक्सेप्ट नहीं किया. और अल्टीमेटली इस बात के लिए काफी एफर्ट हुआ कि पार्टीशन ना हो, बट अल्टीमेटली लॉर्ड माउंटबेटन का जो प्लान था 3 जून 1947 का, उस प्लान के अकॉर्डिंगली इंडिया और पाकिस्तान दो देश बनाने का फैसला हो जाता है. इसके पहले ही अगर हम देखें तो वायलेंस तो था, वो 16 अगस्त 1946 से स्टार्ट हो गया था जबकि मुस्लिम लीग ने डायरेक्ट एक्शन डे डिक्लेयर किया था 16 अगस्त 1946. तो उस समय से जो वायलेंस स्टार्ट हुआ वो वायलेंस फिर रुका नहीं. और 3 जून 1947 को माउंटबेटन प्लान में ये बात क्लियर हो गई कि अब इंडिया का डिवीजन होगा, बिल्कुल फाइनल हो गया था. उसके बाद भी ये जो वायलेंस था वो होता रहा, उसको हम बाद में देखेंगे. अभी फिलहाल जो हमारा नेक्स्ट हम देखने जा रहे हैं वो है प्रोसेस ऑफ पार्टीशन. पार्टीशन का जो प्रोसेस था वो क्या था, उसमें क्या क्या प्रॉब्लम्स हैं, है ना? तो अब हम लोग उसी को डिस्कस करेंगे, प्रोसेस ऑफ पार्टीशन. सबसे बड़ी बात यहाँ पर जो सबसे बड़ी प्रॉब्लम आ रही थी वो ये थी कि जो मुस्लिम कंसंट्रेटेड जो पॉपुलेशन थी वो स्कैटर्ड थी, है ना, एक जो इंडियन सब कॉन्टिनेंट के वेस्टर्न पार्ट में था, दूसरा ईस्टर्न पार्ट में था। तो ये इस तरह के प्रॉब्लम्स जो थे वो हम फेस कर रहे थे पार्टीशन में। वी विल कंटिन्यू विद दिस डिस्कशन इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास।